Welcome everyone once again to Joshua Okwor Online Maths. Still on probability, we have a question here that we will be treating. And the question says that a bag contains 10 balls, of which 6 are red and the rest are white and blue and of equal numbers. If a ball is picked at random, find the probability that it is either white or red, not red, blue or red, probability of white, then E, not red or blue or white. Now, how do we answer this? This is also very, very simple. This is very simple. Please watch this video to the end so that you'll be able to benefit and see how we're going to do this. So, as usual, write what solution. Again, whenever you are solving questions under probability, it is very, very important for you to first bring out your what? Your sample space or your possible outcome. Please bring all of them out. Bring it out, specify it first, and then bring out all your expected what outcome out before you now start answering the question. It's very important to do that. So that is exactly what I'm going to do first now. So number of sample space or possible outcome, okay? Number of what? Sample space. Remember I said sample space. It is same thing as what? Possible outcome is what? A bag contains what? 10 balls. They are what? They are 10. Good. Now, what are the colors? We have what? 6 are red. So how many red do we have there? Red is what? 6. What do you have again? And the rest are white and blue. We have white. How many white do we have there? Remember, I could say that white and blue and of equal numbers. So if we remove 6 from 10, that means we are left with what? With 4. And since the question said that the white and blue are of equal numbers, that means we are dividing 4 by 2. That means I will have what? 2 white. And then how many blue? We also have what? 2 blue. So that by the time you add all of them together, 6 plus 2 plus 2, that will give us what? 10. Now we cannot answer the question because we should find the probability that it is either white or red. That you drew the first one is going to be what? Either white or red. So let's do that here now. So A now. Let's start from here now. Let's see A now. Probability of either white, or red is equals to what number of events over what number of sample space or what total outcome. In other words, number of event means number of what white we have there. Okay, so that will be equals to what number of, how many white do we have in the question? That is 2. That's what, 2 over sample space, that total outcome is what? Is 10. All means what? Plus how many red we have there? Red 6 over 10 also. So the LCM of this and this is actually, you can decide to reduce them, okay? We can actually reduce it, but don't worry, we'll get there. It's 10. This is what? 2 plus 6. So this is equals to 2 plus 6 is what? 8 over 10. 2 here is 4. 2 here is 5. So the answer to that is what? 4 over 5. So probability of getting either white or red is what? 4 over 5. Now let's take the second one. Probability of not red. Good. I like this. Now, in probability, if probability of something occurring is A, probability that that same thing will not occur is 1 minus the probability that it will occur. Do you get that? Please don't forget that. If the probability of something occurring is A, the probability that that same thing will not occur is 1 minus probability that is going to occur. So if this question says we should find probability that is not red, that means probability of what? Of not red is equals to 1 minus probability of what? Of red. Do you get that now? 1 minus probability of what? Of red. So remember that is equals to 1 minus what probability of red? Number of events over number of. So how many red do we have there? We have 6. That was 6 over what? Over 10. This same thing as 1 over 10. So the LCM is 10. This thing as over 1. LCM of 1 and 10 is 10. 10 divided by 1 is 10. 10 times this is what? 10 minus 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1 times 6 is 6. So that is equals to what? 4 over 10. So 2 here is 2. 2 here is what? 5. That gives us what? 2 over 5. That is the answer. So probability that you're not going to pick red is what? Is 2 over 5. Please don't forget this. This is very, very what? Important. The probability of something occurring is A. Probability that that same thing will not occur is 1 minus probability that it will occur. Now C. What is probability of blue or red? C now. Probability of blue or red. Now it's equal to what? Number of events over what? Number of sample space. So let's take that now. Probability of blue. How many blue do we have there? Is 2 over 10 plus how many red do we have there? It's actually what? 6 over 10. We can try to reduce them first. You still get the same answer. This is what? 2 here is what? 1. 2 here is what? 5. 2 here is what? 3. 2 here is what? 5. So if you look at the LCM, it's still 5. No, this is 1 over 5 plus 2 over 5. LCM of this is what? 5. So that is what? 1 plus 2. So that is equals to what? 3 over 5. So the probability of blue or red, probability that is going to pick what? Either blue ball or red ball is what? 3 over 5. That is it. Very simple, isn't it? Very simple. Probability is so interesting because it's actually simple, straightforward. And when you are getting your answer, you know that, yes, my answer is correct. Okay? That is the confidence in maths. I love it. I love maths. And you too should also love maths too. So the next one is for D. Probability of D. Probability of what? Of white. Of picking a white ball. Of course, what number of events over what? Number of sample space. Or total outcome. Remember, this E means expected outcome. And this is a number of what? Total outcome. And this is a total outcome. 10. So what number of expected outcome? That means how many whites we have there. That is 2. Very simple. That is what? 2 over what? 10. 2 here 1. 2 here is what? 5. Equals to 1 over 5. Very simple. Not difficult at all. So let's take the last one now. Not red or blue or white. Ha! If, remember the question said that we have what? 6 red and the rest are blue and red. We have red, blue, and white. Now, if the question said that the person that if a boy is picked at random and you did not pick red, you did not pick blue, or you did not pick white, so what would that be? The answer will automatically be what? Be 0. Okay? Let's see that. Remember, I said that probability of something not occurring is 1 minus probability of that same thing occurring. So let's do that now. Okay? So probability of not what? Not red or blue or white. It's equal to what? Number of events over what? It's equal to 1 minus. It's equal to 1 minus number of events over what? Number of what? Sample space. That means number of all this. Okay? So that now, I'm going to do that now. That will be equal to what? 1 minus. What probability of red? How many red do you have there? 6. 6 over 10 plus. Blue is what? 2 over 10 plus white is what? 2 over 10. Now look at all this. This is what? 1 minus. Look at all this. This is what? All the sum of this is what? Is 10. This is what? 6 plus 2 plus 2. Okay? Which equals to 1 minus 10 over 10. Okay? Which equals to 1. 10 divided by 10 is what? Is 1. 1 minus 1 is equals to what? 0. And that is it. So probability of not picking red or blue or white is equals to what? 0. Of course, you know the answer is going to be 0 because, of course, what we have there, we have red ball, we have blue ball, and we have white ball. So if you do not pick any of those, so that means that the answer is what? Automatically what? 0. Again, don't forget. probability of something not occurring or an event not occurring is 1 minus probability of that event occurring. You can see that from the example that we just solved now. Please, if you enjoy what we are doing here, we encourage you to please share our videos. And then for you to understand this better, mathematics, the key remains practice. Continue to practice. Watch this video over and over again. Try to understand it. Copy this question out. Copy the question and then try to solve it on your own. After copying it, watch this video over and over again. Make sure you understand and then try to solve it on your own. After solving, cross-check and see that your answer is the same what you are having here. Okay? By so doing, your confidence level will continue to grow. Once again, thank you so much for always visiting my channel. Please, watch out for the next video as we see more questions under this topic. Thank you so much. Bye-bye for now.